All right, welcome to episode 3 of the Chatting Cage. Hope you guys are enjoying it. Best series on YouTube, no doubt. Due to limited time, we couldn't film a legitimate intro, so instead here is a man eating toilet paper.
You either bro down or you go down.
Rome wasn't built in a day.
Just fake it until you make it.
Are you terrible at sports? Are you dangerously unathletic? Do you want to make people think you're cooler than you actually are?
We got the fans up in here!
If you answered yes to one or like none of these questions, don't worry. There's Blitzball. It's the softer, less cool version of America's pastime.
Jesus Christ, that's Jason Bourne.
If you want to look like an ensemble of awkwardness, buy Blitzball starting at just $300.
I'm here with Mr. Commissioner himself, Kevin Ravex. Kevin, thanks for being here.
My pleasure.
Three questions.
All right, Kevin, you are the commissioner of the league. What kind of royalties or responsibilities come with such a role?
All right, so the role of the commissioner is to organize when we play and to make sure everyone's behaving themselves, which hasn't been too much an issue, and yeah, just run keep order to the whole situation.
Alright, whatever. What convinced you to turn your backyard into a fortress of plastic perfection?
So, Dylan Ward inspired this. He was a co-founder. Back in middle school, he was a very good pitcher. Things have changed, but so the two of us did it together. We had a big backyard here to do it, so it would have been a shame if we didn't do it.
On a gameplay note, you and Mark Didio are locked in a rivalry for the batting title. Is it friendly competition or is it a rivalry?
I'd say it's definitely a competition. There's no friends in this league, but I'm more concerned about getting my team a ring. I think Didio is more concerned about winning that batting title, so whatever happens, happens.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question. Dylan's got the most swag in the league.
Yo, what up? Dylan Ward. I'm 15 years old and I love the ball. Swag isn't given. You gotta earn it. You gotta own it.
My outfits consist of regularly some nice shoes, some fresh socks, and I gotta have those dope accessories, bro.
Rawlings, Evo Shield, Big League Chew. Yeah, I'm about that life. Looking like a gangster isn't everything. You gotta act like one too. Watch where you're going, nerd.
Just tell me, Doc, what's wrong with me?
You've contracted a rare illness. Narcitis.
Narcitis starts in the peak of one's career. Symptoms include
inability to hit home runs,
inability to run the bases.
Oh my god!
And over hyper aggression.
Come on!
We are trying to find a cure, but it won't be easy. We will track Shane through the season and hopefully see signs of improvement. But the chance is slow. We at the medical center will do everything we can to help him.
Please call this number to help save Shane's fragile career.
Mark Didio has seen a meteoric rise at the plate. After being the worst hitter a season ago, this year he hit for the triple crown. Some compare him to Barry Bonds.
After being the worst hitter a season ago, this year...
We're gonna try and see if we can ask him some questions after he refused to take a drug test from our commissioner. Here he is now. Come on. Mark. Why did you refuse to take a drug test?
No comments.
Have you ever taken performance-enhancing drugs?
Get the camera down my face!
So, you want to learn how to become famous in the wiffle ball community? Well, it's easy. Follow these simple steps, and you can be YouTube famous just like us. Step 1. Videotape your games. Include highlights such as home runs, strikeouts, or whatever else you want to put in it. I don't care. Remember when you're making your video to think of the children. Make sure the music is clean and doesn't have any swear words.
Yellow beats, holla at me.
And chewy and some hot. Like I talk to Shicey when I like you seen him twirl, then he drops. And we keep them to my block.
Step 2. Alright, now that you have your awesome video, share it all over social media and spam people to watch it. Remember, any publicity is good publicity. Step 3. Start to make league t-shirts to make your league look legit. The shirt should look dope. The cooler they are, the cooler your league is. Step 4. Now that your crappy wiffle ball league has become famous, the last step is pretty simple. All you have to do is keep uploading, and you've got it. And most importantly, have fun.
It's rolling! Don't tell me to chill!
Yeah, no, I gotta do the outro. Yeah, I'll call you back. Alright. Alright, hope you enjoyed that episode. Comment below any questions you have. We'll try to answer them. You guys didn't really ask any last time. What the hell? That was annoying. But yeah, hope you enjoyed it. Episode 4 coming out soon. I think it's gonna be the best one yet. Stay tuned.
Go berserk. Go berserk.